Good morning, learners. Today we are going to start with the first poem in your course, which is called The Ant and the Cricket. This poem is adapted from Aesop's Fables. Now, who was Aesop? Aesop was an ancient Greek storyteller. He was a writer who wrote a lot of children's stories or fables, as we call them. In the video, I will explain what fables actually mean. For now, let's move on to the introduction of the poem. This is a fable that conveys a moral. So at the end of this poem, there will be a moral, something that you will learn at the end of the poem. It revolves around the universal idea of the importance of hard work. What do we mean by universal? Universal is something which is accepted everywhere. It is very, very common. In every culture, everywhere, people will tell you to work hard. So this fable, this poem that you're going to read, which is based on this fable, will tell you the importance of hard work. This poem is written in a conversational tone. What do we mean by conversation? A conversation is an exchange between any two or more people, right? So a conversation is sort of a talk between two or more people. This poem is written in a conversational tone. So there are two main characters, like the title suggests, the ant and the cricket, and they both are in a conversation. So now, what is a fable? A fable is a traditional story that teaches us a moral lesson. Like I told you, there is a moral lesson at the end of every fable. There is something that every child learns from a fable. Usually, the characters in fables are animals. So to make it interesting for the children, the characters are generally animals, and these animals are generally capable of talking and, you know, conversing in the language that we generally use. This poem also teaches us a very important moral lesson of being industrious like an ant. It also teaches us we should not be lazy like the cricket. So industrious means to be hardworking. So this story on which the poem is based, it tells us the importance of being hardworking like the ant, and it also tells you not to be lazy like the cricket was. Moving ahead, now let's move on to the poem which is based on this story. You can do one thing, you can pause the video at places where there is the poem and you can read it for yourself, or you can go ahead and read it with me as I read. I'm going to read the first stanza now. A silly young cricket, accustomed to sing through the warm sunny months of gay summer and spring, began to complain when he found that at home his cupboard was empty and winter was come. Not a crumb to be found on the snow-covered ground, not a flower could he see, not a leaf on a tree. Oh, what will become, says the cricket, of me? Let's go back to the first stanza. Let's see. A silly young cricket. So he's a foolish young cricket, and he's accustomed. Accustomed means he's very used to. So he's accustomed to sing. What does he do? He sings. He sings through the warm sunny months of gay. Gay means happiness. Gay months of summer and spring. So what does he do? He just sits idle. He just sings around and lazes around and goes here and there being happy and singing and chirping around. He doesn't do any work. Began to complain when he found that at home. So the winters have come now, right? His cupboard was empty and winter was come. So winters have come now and he has started to complain. He is not very happy now. He has started to complain. And what is he complaining about? Why is he complaining? Because he has found out that at his home he has nothing to eat, because he did not do any work, he did not save any food during the summers. So now he doesn't have anything to eat. Now he is not very happy and he is complaining. Not a crumb to be found. What is a crumb? A crumb is a very, very small piece of bread. So not a crumb to be found on the snow covered ground, because it is winters and there is nothing on the ground. There are no plants, no trees, no fruits, nothing. He does not have anything to eat. There is not even a single crumb. So he's very worried now. Not a flower could he see, not a leaf on the tree. So because everything is covered with snow, it is so cold, there is no grass, no fruits, nothing there, not even a single leaf on the trees. And the grasshopper is very worried now. Oh, what will become, says the cricket, of me? So he's asking himself, he's wondering, oh, what will become of me? What will happen to me? How will I live now? How will I survive? So he's thinking to himself. He's very worried. Moving to the second stanza, I'll read it. At last, by starvation and famine made bold, all dripping with wet and all trembling with cold, away he set off to a miserly ant to see if to keep him alive he would grant him shelter from rain, a mouthful of grain. He wished only to borrow, he'd repay it tomorrow. If not, he must die of starvation and sorrow. At last, by starvation and famine made bold. So what do we mean by starvation and famine? Both the word have a similar meaning, hunger. So at last, by starvation and famine made bold. So he took a very, very bold decision. Why did he take a bold decision? Because he was starving, he was very, very hungry. So he took the bold step, all dripping with wet and all trembling with cold. So he was dripping with water. So he goes out and it is raining outside. He's totally wet, dripping. Water is dripping from his body. And all trembling with cold, because it is so cold, he's literally shivering, trembling, shaking with cold, right? Away he set off to a miserly ant. So he goes out of his home. It is already raining. It's very, very cold. And he sets off. Sets off means to go ahead. He said to start a journey, right? He sets off to a miserly ant. Miserly means very poor. So he goes to the place of a very, very poor ant to see if to keep him alive he would grant. To grant is to give something. So he wanted to go to the ant's house and to see if to keep him alive he would give him something. He wanted to see if the ant will give him something to help him survive the winter months, survive the cold. Him shelter from rain. Now what is the first thing that he wanted? He wanted a shelter from the rain. He wanted the ant to let him inside his house and to shelter him from the rain, because it was raining so hard. A mouthful of grain. What else does he want? Mouthful of grain. Grain means something to eat. So he wanted something to eat to survive. He wished only to borrow. He'd repay it tomorrow. So he says, I only wish to borrow. Please lend it to me. I will give it to you tomorrow. Now, tomorrow does not mean the day after, you know. Here, tomorrow means in the summer month. So he says, please give me something to eat. I will give it to you. I will give it back to you during the summer months. If not, he must die of starvation and sorrow. So he says that if you don't give me any food and shelter right now, I will die of starvation, I will die of hunger, I will die of famine and sorrow. Sorrow means sadness. So he says that I will be very, very sad and I'm going to die of famine and sorrow if you don't help me with any food. Now the third stanza. Says the ant to the cricket, I'm your servant and friend, but we ants never borrow, we ants never lend. But tell me, dear sir, did you lay nothing by when the weather was warm? Said the cricket, not I. My heart was so light that I sang day and night, for all nature looked gay. You sang, sir, you say? Go then, said the ant, and dance winter away. Thus ending, he hastily lifted the wicket, and out of the door turned the poor little cricket. Though this is a fable, the moral is good. If you live without work, you must live without food. Now I'll explain the third stanza to you. Says the ant to the cricket. So now, till now, the cricket was speaking to the ant. Now the ant is speaking to the cricket. And what does he say? He says, I'm your servant and friend. I'm your servant also, and I'm your friend as well. But we ants never borrow, we ants never lend. The ant says, I am sorry, we never take anything from anybody, and we don't give anything to anybody as a debt also. So I can't really give you anything, I am sorry. But tell me, dear sir, did you lay nothing by? Lay nothing by means, did you not keep anything aside? Did you not save any food during the summers? Tell me, dear sir, did you not save anything? when the weather was warm. So the aunt is questioning the cricket right now. Did you not put aside any food for yourself when it was summers? Said the cricket, not I. So what does the cricket say? He says, sorry, not I. I did not do it. My heart was so light that I sang day and night. He says, my heart was very light. Now, light does not mean the opposite of heavy here. Light means very, very happy. So he says, my heart was so light. I was so happy. I was busy in merrymaking. I was so cheerful that I sang day and night. I kept on singing day and night. I was very happy. I kept roaming around. For all nature looked gay. Nature looked so happy and I could not control myself. You sang, sir, you say? Go then, said the ant, and dance winter away. So the ant gets a little angry now. He says, are you telling me that you kept on singing all day? You sang, sir, you say? Are you saying that you sang all day? So if you did that, then go away and dance the winter away. You know, so he says, if you sang all the summer, you must go and dance now in the winters, right? Thus ending, he hastily lifted the wicket. Hastily means in a hurry, quickly. So thus ending, so he ended the conversation there. Thus ending means the conversation abruptly ended there, because the ant said, no, sorry, I will not give you any food. If you wasted your summer months like that, go ahead. I will not give you anything for the winters. He hastily lifted the wicket and out of the door turned the poor little cricket. So the poor little cricket was thrown out of the door. The ant said, no, I cannot help you. I will not give you anything to eat. Though this is a fable, the moral is good. So the poet says, though this is only a fable, it is just a story, the moral is good. You should learn something from it. And what is the moral? If you live without work, you must live without food. So if you are not ready to work today, you must learn how to live without food. Right? In your cases, what is your work right now? You are supposed to study. So if you don't study today, you should learn to live with less marks tomorrow. You should learn to live without a job tomorrow. If you don't put in efforts today, if you don't prepare today, you will face a lacking in the future. Moving on to the themes now. We'll discuss four major themes. First is the importance of preparation. Second is saving for a rainy day. Third is work before play. And fourth is striking a balance. Now, let me explain the second theme now. First, saving for a rainy day. What does it mean? Rainy day does not literally mean a day when it rains. It means that you save for a day when you will actually face a problem. So supposing your parents give you some pocket money daily, right? And you save half of it. So after a while, after a year or so, maybe if you ever face a problem wherein you need some money, you can always go back to your savings, take out some money and spend it on whatever you need, right? What if your parents give you a lot of money and you waste all of it in a single day? There will come a time when you will face a problem and you will not have anything, any savings to spend from. So that's why it is very, very important to prepare for the future, to be ready for the future and to save for a rainy day, save for a day where you will face a problem so that you can go back to your savings, right? Let's move on to the first theme, importance of preparation. When we are young, we must spend our time working and planning for the future. So you should not waste time. You should not be, you should not just have fun. You should also start preparing for your future. You should start putting in efforts for your future so that you can bank upon the efforts that you made today. Those who do not plan in advance never can get the work done in time. So their work is always haphazard. Their work is always, you know, unordered. Their work is not tidy at all. So if you don't plan in advance, you will never be able to get your work done. So you always have to plan it in advance. Just like during your exams, you start revising a month before. You don't just leave everything for the last day, right? That's what you need to do. The cricket enjoyed the sunny moments. I told you, he was very happy. He enjoyed the summers and spring and did not think of the cold and difficult moments of the winter. If you ignore the occurrence of a bad day, if you ignore that something like this could happen, when it happens, you will face a lot of issues. The ant, on the other hand, is completely opposite than the cricket. His nature is completely opposite. He was occupied all through the summer. Occupied means busy. all through the summer and spring. What was he doing? He was collecting food for the winter and storing it safely for the winters. Now the other themes, work before play and striking a balance. It is important to be fully prepared for the future. Start working today to make your tomorrow better. So if you want to make your future, if you want to become something in the future, you have to start today. Even if you want to become a dancer, you cannot do it in one day, right? You have to keep on practicing starting today. You have to keep on practicing for years and years to become a good dancer or whatever else you want to become in the future, right? So it is very, very important to prepare for the future. Put in the efforts. One should know one's priorities. You should value work before play. You should know what to do when. You should know what is more important in life. Always complete your work before and then go out to play. Because playing is something that everybody likes, you know. And working is very hard. So you have to complete the hard work before and then you can go on and relax and rest. That's what each one of us needs to do. Everything is in life is important, but it is important to strike a balance between work and play to make your life better. So there are 100 things that you can do in a day and not all of them are important, right? You have to balance very carefully what to do, what not to do, right? You have to keep track of your time, maintain like a proper routine and follow that. If you put in those efforts, you will surely get good results in the future. Moving on to the conclusion, you have two characters here, the ant and the cricket. The ant represents the people who are wise and bold. So the people who are, who think at the right time, who are very bold, who keep on working very hard, very sincere in whatever they do. The ant represents those people who can face all kinds of situations with determination. So determination means when you're very, very adhere strictly to something that you decide, when you're very convinced about something, that's called being determined about something, right? So the people who determine to work hard always are successful at the end. They are strong and powerful and good planners. So they plan in advance, they are very good planners, so that's why they get good results. The cricket, on the other hand, represents the people who live in the moment. So these are the people who are happy in the moment. They don't think about the future. They just relax and chill around. They do not work for the future, right? These people do not think about the future and therefore pay the price of their ignorance. Because they waste time, so the time that they have wasted never comes back to them, right? They are not sincere and are only interested in merrymaking and enjoyment. Like I told you, so if they make fun of time, the time is not going to respect them ever. So these are the two characters and they represent different peoples in our lives also. Now you can ask a question, what do you learn from this poem? Why is this poem in your course? Now I'll tell you my own answer. You can interpret it in your own ways also. What I think is that this poem, Mark, is the very first poem in your course. So it tells you at the very beginning that you have a whole year ahead of you. You need to plan in advance. You need to start studying right now, today itself, so as to get good results when the actual day of the result comes, right? So to get a successful future, to make yourself a better person, it is very important to prepare, to work hard, to work sincerely for it, and to not just laze around and sing like the cricket did.